want to warn you, this story has graphic images. Tonight, the Hinds County Sheriff's Office says pictures we brought to their attention are the key piece of evidence behind a mass firing at the Hinds County Jail.
As 16 WAPT's Aaron Kelly reports, now authorities are investigating whether the pictures could lead to federal charges.
Obviously, that was not the condition that he came to the jail.
Our cameras were rolling last month when murder suspect Charles Johnson walked into court with two black eyes. He's the man accused of killing a man and carjacking a FedEx truck to escape police. Family members sent us these graphic photos of Johnson just after he turned himself in. We brought the pictures to the Hinds County Sheriff's Department 3 weeks ago.
And this investigation came out of the complaint that was made to WAPT.
Last week, the sheriff fired 8 detention officers after he says surveillance video showed inappropriate force against other inmates. Now McMillan says his office is also looking into whether guards beat up Charles Johnson.
This could be an ongoing part of an investigation that we're already doing concerning mistreatment of detainees by detention personnel.
Johnson's family says he claimed he was beaten unconscious. They told us, quote, having a badge doesn't give you the right to beat and abuse these men, no matter what they have done. The sheriff's department says Johnson had a history of fighting with officers, and they say it's even possible other inmates beat him.
Charles Johnson is being held here at the downtown Hinds County Detention Center, and authorities tell us his family requested that he be moved here from the Raymond facility because they were concerned about his safety.
We asked the sheriff who's accountable for making sure inmates are safe in jail.
I'm accountable for it. They're my responsibility.
Prison rights lawyer Ron Welch says regardless of who beat Charles Johnson, there's been a problem in Mississippi jails for a long time.
I'm just delighted, from my point, I'm delighted that we have authorities who are looking into this as a criminal matter. Listen, we've got a history, where that doesn't happen.
The Hinds County District Attorney says the case could go to a grand jury and officers could face a felony or jail time if they're convicted. In Jackson, Erin Kelly, 16 WAPT News.
Now, we have all of the pictures online, and we would like to hear what you think about this case. Log on to WAPT.com to leave your comments and your feedback.